so much like home. Hand in hand, we're all part of a bigger plan that you and I get to explore all our own. Every day I will fall more in love with you in every way. Every day I will fall more in love with you in every way. In every way. Every day in every way. Walk with me. Let's tell our own story, the one about trust, the one about us. And I just can't believe that I got everything at a fingertip's touch, and I can't get enough. Every day I will fall more in love with you in every way.
Close to you.
Ooh, 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 ooh.
Our Father in heaven, we stand here in this wonderful moment surrounded by our family and our friends, and we thank you for your great love for us. Thank you that you love the world so much that you sent your one and only Son, Jesus Christ, that whoever confesses that Jesus is Lord and believes in his name shall be saved and have eternal life. We invite you, God, here right now in this moment to bless this marriage of Allie and Blake. Especially bless Allie and Blake as they come together in this marriage tonight. Amen. Allie and Blake, we want to just take a moment before we get this going, just to take it all in, just in the silence between you and between God, just so you can get the feel of it all for the beauty, the majesty. So you can look over your shoulders and you can see your friends and your family, see their smiles. Just take a moment and do that right now. On behalf of Blake and Allie, I'd like to welcome you tonight to this beautiful evening. May thank you so much for your friendship, for your love, for your care, and for your support in joining them to witness this marriage this evening. My name is Don Petty, and I am Allie's uncle, and I'll be officiating tonight. I have so many fond memories of Allie when she was young because our families had spent a lot of time together. One particular time when Allie was little, we went camping, and there was a rather violent storm that evening, and everyone was in a different tent. And after a particularly loud crack of thunder, you could hear Allie cry out, "Family!" Her younger self needed the reassurance that we were all there and that she wasn't alone in this scary moment. Now, family is kind of a running quip that we use occasionally when we don't know where everybody is. But it's clear to all of us that Allie and Blake have a very special love. As we heard last night during the speeches, you guys met on Blake's 21st birthday. And in that 7 years together, you've done a whole lot in your young adult lives, like college graduations and new jobs and moving across the country, and then new jobs and moving across the country again, and then new jobs, and you get what I'm saying. I believe that the two of you knew that evening 7 years ago, that cry family would be a pivotal part of your relationship. Because tonight, as your love has been forged through, you know, some incredible joys and some grief in which you supported and you protected and you cared for each other and you stood by each other. And today, in this big moment of marriage, all that joy and that grief gets intertwined so tightly they become kind of indispensable, that they are indistinguishable, that they form that bond of family. So Allie, your dad was my best friend, and I know he's here with us right now, and he is so proud of you, and he is so thankful that Blake is the person that you chose. And Blake, I am so happy that you are officially going to be part of our family, which of course comes with all the rights and privileges of our quote family Snapchat, of which Blake has been waiting a very long time. So that, of course, comes with all sorts of rights and all sorts of privileges to do share your life on Snapchat. So congratulations. From what you shared with me about your father, Blake, how he instilled in you a work ethic and how that probably is only understood by an oldest child, and the honor and the integrity that he instilled with you, I know right now that he would be beaming right here in the front seat, and he would be so proud of you. And he would be an overwhelming approval of Allie. So Allie and Blake, we are all here to support you. No one knows what storms are going to come in the future, in the years ahead for sure, but one thing, you are not alone. And always remember that call out to each other as Allie did that evening. And remember family and how much you are cared for. So Blake and Allie would like to light a candle in remembrance of their fathers, Will Chingross and Ray Lee. And now there'll be a reading from 1 John 4:7.
1 John chapter 4. Dear friends, let us love one another, for love comes from God. Everyone who loves has been born of God and knows God. Whoever does not love does not know God, because God is love. This is how God showed his love among us. He sent his one and only Son into the world that we might live through him. This is love, not that we loved God, but that he loved us and sent his Son as an atoning sacrifice for our sins.
At this time, Blake and Allie would like to take communion in remembrance of Christ's sacrifice. So please, silently, would you join them in sending them prayers and your love? Blake and Allie have written some personal vows for each other, and at this time they will read them.
Allie, over the last 7 years, you and I have experienced a lot of changes. New jobs, new cities, too many new apartments, and ups and downs with family. But despite everything we've been through, all the twists and turns, you've been the one consistent rock in my life. You've taught me how to be fiercely loyal and how to show grace and forgiveness in situations where I would not. You've demonstrated to me what true resilience looks like. And I can safely say with 100% certainty that I am who I am only because of you. And I'm not sure where I would be if you hadn't taken that chance. Decided to take that chance on that guy wearing a Christmas-themed Hawaiian shirt in the middle of June. But whether it was when you flew across country at 3 a.m. to help me through one of the darkest times of my life, or where you made us wake up at 4 a.m. to watch the royal wedding in 2018, I remember thinking, you know, this is a complete waste of time. But over those few hours in the morning, when it was just me and you in that cramped New York apartment, there was no other place I'd rather be, and with no other person I'd rather spend this time with than you. What I'm really trying to say is our love is selfless, it's genuine, doesn't matter where we are, or what we're doing, or who we're with. Our love is the type of love that makes me excited to go to bed every night, knowing I get to wake up next to you every morning. And we both recognize how special it is and it's worth fighting for each and every day. The love that we have, love that we have been given, is understanding, unique, and a true gift from God with a little help from our dads. You've given me more than I could ever have imagined when we first met that summer 7 years ago. Most importantly, you've given me the gift of a loving family, welcoming me with arms wide open. And standing here today, I'm getting so excited just thinking about all the things that we're gonna do and accomplish together, and just how you're gonna be the best, absolute best, caring and loving mom in the whole entire world. I love you with all my heart. Now let's celebrate.
Okay, Blake, unlike most girls, I didn't really grow up daydreaming about my wedding or fantasizing about my future husband, although my mom sure did. She prayed for him all the time, and I'm pretty sure my Nana did too. Of course, I always knew I wanted to get married and have a beautiful wedding. What I mean is that I didn't have big expectations or a checklist of requirements for him to meet. But I did hope that he'd love God and be ridiculously good looking. I once heard that the best litmus test for a life partner has to do with a well-known Bible verse from 1 Corinthians. Love is patient. Love is kind. It does not envy. It does not boast. It is not proud. It goes on to list all the attributes of true love. To pass the test, you need to replace the word love with that person's name. Tears welled in my eyes as I read. Blake is patient. Blake is kind. Blake does not envy. Blake does not boast. Blake is not proud. Blake does not dishonor others. Blake is not self-seeking. Blake is not easily angered. Blake keeps no record of wrongs. Blake does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. Blake always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always perseveres. Blake never fails. Each one was truer than the last. I'm so glad I didn't picture my future husband. He would have fallen so short in comparison to the man that you are. You are the man my mom prayed for since I was a child. The one my dad in heaven made sure I got to marry. You are everything I could have hoped and dreamed for and more. We've been through so much individually and as a couple, things that have tested our faith and broken our hearts. But through it all, our love for each other has only grown deeper. After almost 7 years, we do not get sick of each other. In fact, it's the opposite. I miss you when you're gone for even an hour. Every moment in life, big or small, is made infinitely better when I share it with you. I love you more than I'll ever be able to express, and I am so blessed to become your wife.
Well, now Blake and Allie will make vows to each other. Blake, do you take Allie to be your lawfully wedded wife and to live together in the promise of marriage, promising to listen to her, to learn from her, to support her, and to accept her support through the pressures of the present and the uncertainties of the future?
I do.
Do you promise to be a faithful friend, a partner in life that you make together, loving and having faith in her love for you, forsaking all others, and to be faithful to her through all that life may bring as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Allie, do you take Blake to be your husband and to live together in the promise of marriage, promising to listen to him and to learn from him and to support him and accept his support through the pressures of the present and the uncertainties of the future?
I do.
Do you promise to be a faithful friend and a partner in the life you make together, loving and having faith in his love for you, forsaking all others, and be faithful to him through all that life may bring as long as you both shall live?
I do.
So Blake, as you place the ring on Allie's finger, please repeat after me. Allie, I give you this ring.
Allie, I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my vows.
As a symbol of my vows.
Today, I join my life with yours.
Today, I join my life with yours.
In the presence of God and our family.
In the presence of God and our family.
Allie, repeat after me. Blake, I give you this ring.
Blake, I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my vows.
As a symbol of my vows.
Today, I join my life with yours.
Today, I join my life with yours.
In the presence of God and our family.
In the presence of God and our family.
Blake and Allie, with the greatest joy in my heart, I now pronounce you husband and wife. You may kiss your bride.
I close my eyes and we're dancing. I close my eyes, but I can't sleep. I pray I drift away before the sunrise, so I can hold you for a minute in my dreams. Oh, what I'd give to kiss your lips and spin you around one more time. I'm still holding on to the moments we were given. I miss your love, I miss your light shining in the kitchen. Baby, this house, yeah, this whole town ain't the same without you in them. Sent to save me, you made every street turn to gold. My paradise, my sweet by and by. If time heals all, then tell me why. I'm still
we Well, we just wanted to give a quick welcome to all of you. On behalf of Carolyn and myself, we really just want to thank you all for being here. We know it's been a trek for a lot of people, but what a beautiful place and a beautiful event. And we couldn't be happier to see you all here. And most importantly, Blake and Allie, you're such special people, all of you, to them, that it's a beautiful occasion to have you here. I would say welcome and have a good time, but judging by early indications, the dancing and the drinking is such that I think it's already begun. So Carolyn, why don't you just say hello too, and then let's kick this off.
Thank you. I know, like as Tom said, many of you traveled from the East Coast. You've had car rides that were long, and we just appreciate you being here. We know it was not easy to come this way, but we hope that you're having as great of a time as we are. And when I look around and I see all of these people here, I know how much you love Blake and Lovey, and it touches our hearts that you would be here with us. You're here because we love each one of you, and we wanted you to be here because we care about you. And this day so far has just exceeded all of my expectations, and I think Lovey and Blake feel the same. I love these two. I love these two so much. I got to really know Blake through COVID. We lived together. We lived together for about a year, and I don't know how many people can say that they really know their son-in-law, but I really know my son-in-law. And when I say that he is everything, like Lovey said, he's everything that I prayed for and more. Except, you know, he's not handsome, but but he has a really good personality. And so, and I just want to talk about my little Lovey. Somebody, okay, I just want to say, like, I think if you know me, you know how close we are, and seeing here right now is touches my heart, and you are my heart, and I love you guys. Okay, let's have fun.
Yep. We'll be back with more emotion later on.
Couple of comments. Blake, you can't check till tomorrow, but there's been a welcome Snapchat already filmed for you. And I don't think we could start this evening without thanking God for parting the clouds and giving us beautiful sunshine for your wedding tonight. If you'd bow your heads for a moment. Dear Heavenly Father, we ask that you continue your presence during this celebration tonight of Blake and Allie's wedding. We celebrate their commitment and decision to spend the rest of their lives together. We are invested as family and friends in the next chapter in their lives. And together we hope and have anticipation while we watch this play out. We ask that you bless our time together tonight as we dine in fellowship, together hearing stories that may make us laugh and cry, and hearing music that lifts up our spirits. And we will praise you with dancing as this is pleasant to you. You are smiling from heaven, and I hope we honor you, and this is pleasing in your sight. Amen.
Gonna let you down. I'm gonna go all out on you. Thank you, everyone, on behalf of the Lee family who came so from far and near, making this day so special for Blake and Allie. This will be a cherished memory as the formal beginning of a lifelong journey together for them. When Blake asked me to say a few words today, I was honored. Blake's father and I were best friends, and we had the opportunity to spend a lot of time together and to raise our families together, and our kids grew up together. And Blake, leading up to today, I thought about your father, you know, a lot. And I really miss him. And I really miss that he's not here. He would have been tremendously proud of you and your decision to marry Allie and her decision to say yes. So yeah, some of you met last night at the rehearsal dinner. My son, Sam and Blake have been best friends since they were about 3 years old. Blake was always the gentle giant around our house. He was bigger than most kids his own age, but he was the kid that you wanted your kids to be around. All the parents wanted their kids to be hanging out with Blake, because he was such a good role model, made such good decisions even at a young age, and I'm sure kept my son Sam out of jail probably more than once. I'm sure there's things that we have no idea about. Not only is Blake an incredible person, as everyone knows, he's very driven, persistent, and talented. He got into water polo at a young age, and he drove that to prep school in San Diego and then on to Harvard, where he won many accolades and was a terrific water polo player and a terrific student. Blake, we couldn't be happier for you and for all of your success. I'd like to mention my wife, Kimiko, who's here. I'm gonna stand up or wave or something. Anyway, we're here to celebrate your marriage to Allie. Allie, welcome to the family. This is the beginning of a great journey for you two. We are so happy and blessed to have you as part of our family and part of the Lee family. We're looking forward to watching you and Blake build your life and family together. You should know, however, Blake has always been tough as nails, when you have children, you're going to want to remember that Blake has a very weak stomach. As Blake, I'm sure, can tell you, Sam could and would, with great satisfaction, make Blake throw up for any reason or no reason on demand. Really, though, Blake will be an awesome father. Allie, you're the sunshine in Blake's life. He adores you. You two were born to be together. To Allie's family, thank you for raising such a special and wonderful young woman who loves Blake so dearly. Blake, your father would be so proud of all you've accomplished, and prouder still of the man you have become and the way you live your life. He would be so happy right now with your marriage to Allie. And Allie, Ray would be so grateful to have you as a daughter-in-law. Finally, Blake, a little advice for a happy, long, and successful marriage. I want you to memorize these three phrases and use them in all the dodgy situations that you're sure to get yourself into. So you might want to write this down, but I'll give you this speech later and you can have it. But number one, yes, dear. Number two, you're right, dear. And number three, whatever you want, dear. Blake and Allie, we love you both. May all your wishes and dreams come true. Here's to a long and happy life together as Mr. and Mrs. Lee. Congratulations.
The matter took a long way. We knew we'd get there someday. They said, I bet they'll never make it. But just look at us holding on. We're still together, still going strong. Still, you're still the one I run to, the one that I belong to. You're still the one I want for life. Still, you're still the one that I love, the only one I dream of. You're still the one I kiss goodnight. Ain't nothing better. We beat the odds together. I'm glad we didn't listen. Look at what we would be missing. They said, I bet they'll never make it. But just look at us holding on.
So welcome everyone again. Really, Carolyn and I are so happy to be at this occasion and celebrate this wonderful couple's wedding. It's really amazing. And like, it's been great to get to know the Lee family better at this weekend. And like with Blake's dad, Ray, I mean, we have to remember Allie's dad, Will, what an important person he was in Allie's life. And again, how proud he would be to be here. And so much love from him on behalf of the family. As you can imagine, more than a little bit of blood, sweat, and tears went into this event. True to character, Allie planned and executed this wedding to perfection. It's part of her personality. So first off, congratulations to this very beautiful couple. My sister, Lisa, very cleverly noted that Allie and Blake look so perfect that they're like those people whose photo you get when you buy a picture frame. And it's true. And, you know, it's only matched by the other people in the wedding party. Really, this is very damaging to most normal people's psyches. But they're special people inside and out. So Allie and Blake have been together for 7 years. And they've been through an amazing amount of external drama, not of their own creation, that would have seriously damaged the relationship of most people. What's really amazing is how strong their relationship is, how they've weathered all of these serious bumps in the road and more, and their love for each other just continues to seem to grow over time. So that's really an amazing gift. They really do get each other. We've really come to know and love Blake, who's become part of our family. That handsome surfer guy, water polo star, Harvard-educated guy, is smart, he's hardworking, he's driven to succeed. That's not a bad combination. But more importantly, Blake is truly a warm and caring person. He understands when to act and when to listen. He's kind and patient, and he knows how to support Allie emotionally. And that's a very important trait going forward. Blake has been a regular fixture at the Chingros Cox Merrill Petty family events and has really become a part of those very special and wonderful families. So Blake, we're just so happy that you're in Allie's life, and we couldn't ask for a better son-in-law for our daughter. Allie, I don't know, what is there to say about Allie? Allie's a perfectionist in every way. I learned that when I met her as a 12-year-old, but it's been well documented that she's been that way essentially from the time she was a toddler. Carolyn tells a story about Allie reorganizing her closets basically when she was 3 years old.
Two years old,
okay. And that's not surprising once you get to know Allie. Whether it's making a cake, a TikTok video, or a wedding, there just are no shortcuts or accepting less than the very best. I've seen this. I watched Allie bake the most amazing cake where it's taken her 3 hours to make it and there's something that's just not right and she scraps it and she starts from scratch all over again. To, you know, with this kind of devotion, Lovey's Bakery had no shot to have an acceptable profit margin. Setting up a new college dorm room or a New York City apartment, which, by the way, was an annual event for way too many years, was a gruelingly painstaking exercise. Allie and Blake, or Allie before that, seemed to move more than a person in witness protection. It's really unbelievable. But there was no settling for anything less than Allie's vision in that. As Blake well knows, this presents some challenges from time to time and requires a lot of patience. But the results are always amazing and worth the effort. Simply speaking, Allie was born to be a boss. As a 12-year-old, she threatened to, quote, hunt me down and kill me, unquote, if I didn't bring her mother back safely from one of our first dates. And I kind of believed it. As a 16-year-old, without our knowledge, she made an appointment for us with a real estate agent to see a house she found in Vegas. A house we, of course, thought was perfect and wound up buying and moving into. She planned our vacations. She generally handled all dinner reservations, home decor choices, and overall scheduling for the family. As Nick can attest, Nick has had two mothers since birth. But underneath that exterior, as an exacting boss and an overall tough guy, lies a complete marshmallow. The aptly nicknamed Lovey will do anything and everything in support of her close friends and family. She loves to be pampered and is fiercely loyal. She's the best daughter, sister, or friend a person could have. One of the happiest days of my life was being able to adopt Allie and Nick, and she's just the most wonderful person you can imagine. I love you and feel so fortunate to be here today and part of your life. What is most special, though, is the relationship between Allie and this person right here, Carolyn. At times, it could be a bit daunting. It's like dealing with two versions of the same person. They finish each other's thoughts. They think about things at the same time. It's really almost like your tag team 24 hours a day. But what is clear is the unconditional love and loyalty that Allie and Carolyn have for each other. They've shared a lot of happy times, sad times, and outright tragedies together. They always are there for each other in the most deep and amazing way. There's really an amazing and special bond between them. And Carolyn is and always has been the most loving and supportive parent a child could have. It's not hard to see where Lovey's best traits come from. So Allie and Blake, we want to say congratulations to you. Here's to a long and happy life together. And if Mom wants to add to that so we can get some more emotion going here, let's do it.
Hi, thank you. I don't have anything else, but I just thought of this. I have two things I want like to mention. First, I want to thank my mom and dad. So my parents have been married for over 63 years. And they have really modeled what I think God has in mind for a marriage and a loving marriage. When you guys took those vows tonight, you said, you know, for better, for worse, in sickness and in health. And, you know, some days are going to be easier than others. And we have a Nana and a Papa that have shown us what commitment is, and when you take those vows, you better mean them, because it's serious. And we have, you know, Mom and Dad, you haven't just been there for my sisters and me, but for your grandchildren. What you've shown them is so, so special, and we just love you so much, and we're so glad you're here. We're blessed. We're blessed to have this foundation and this example. We love you. We love you so much. And I also have to thank this man, because he has been there since Lovey was a little brat. And Nick loved him from the first time he met Tom, because Tom would throw the football and there was some guy energy there, and Nick was all in. Lovey was having none of it until she realized what a special person this man is and has been and continues to be in their life. I don't know what I would have done without you, Tom. You have really been there and shown up in some really scary times and some good times, and the kids love you. We love you, and we thank you for all that you've done for them over the years. Thank you.
Thank you.
But so let's one more toast here. Come on, let's get this together.
Yes.
Good job, Mom. Great job, Mom. Great job, Allie and Blake.
Congratulations. We love you guys. We love you so much. Now let's have fun. Woo! Yes, today.